You know I hate sleeping alone, but you said that you would soon be home. But baby, that was a long time ago. I'm not feeling it, I'm not feeling it. On top of you not calling me back, you see, I bet you think it's all on track, and you acting like it's all a act. I'm not feeling it, I'm not feeling it. I'm taking back.
Are going to be probably the what we're gonna be doing today about the title, but I know I'm late with the Fenty game, but I went to Sephora because I was trying to figure out what I wanted. I really kind of didn't think, oh, I want foundation, but I know that I've been using this one foundation forever, and I'm like, okay, maybe it's I do need foundation. I'm just going to go ahead and review a couple of products that I got today from Fenty and see how I look all day long, how it wears, how long it lasts, what it feels like on my skin, all that good stuff. So stay tuned because we're about to get into it. So what I got from Fenty is I got the primer, I got the foundation, and I got the concealer, and I got the bronzing powder. So I'm about to show you everything, but I'm gonna start with the primer since that's the first thing I'm gonna be using. That's what I'm gonna show first. So this is the Soft Silk. I do have combo skin, more on the dry side, really like normal, but more normal dry, if that makes sense. Still combo. It's Instant Hydration Soft Silk Finish Extended Make-A-Wear, which is the part that I really want. And of course, you know, this is more for dry skin. It's the Pro Filter primer, and this is what it looks like. I know a lot of people know what it looks like, but I'm still finna act. She's acting up just like I'm finna act. Like, this is new. It is new, actually. This one is new. This primer is new, but the foundation and the concealer is not new, but in the powder, but it's okay.
I don't know, I think it's like pinkish looking in the bottle.
You can't tell, but I think it's more of a nude. So this is the bottle. It's really pretty. I like that it's very simple. The Fenty lime. So I have my little beauty blender, and I'm just gonna, you know how you when you first open something, it doesn't come out, like, come out. Ooh. So I did three pumps because I don't know, I'm just one of those people, I like to feel it on my face. It smells like, which I already knew this because me and my sister played with it a little bit in the Sephora and that where I live, but
I'm choosing a foundation, but I don't know where to head. And obviously the Sephora girls are gonna try to help me. I don't really want help, but I'll accept it today. Only to find my foundation. I don't need help choosing. I'm gonna deliberately, slowly make my mind up.
It smells like baby powder, but it smells like the baby, the kind of baby powder when you first open a new baby alive or something. I'm a living doll. But it feels really good. It's not super like overly hydrating, which I love. I don't know, I feel like it feels good. I felt it on my hand, I knew it was gonna feel good, but yeah. I'm gonna put one more, like a half a pump on this side. And I matched myself. I did not let them match me. Last time I let a girl match me at Sephora, she got me the wrong shade. It was the Too Faced, and I should have got Chestnut instead of getting the color before Chestnut, which I can't think of the name. I have it, but I don't remember the name of it. And so at first I was matching to my face, which I obviously know that's a no-no. I did it on my neck. My face and my neck are very similar, but my neck is a little more bronzy, and my face is more yellow, which obviously that makes sense. Your face, especially in the inner cheek area, nose area, is gonna be a little lighter than like the outside and the neck area. But so I mean, I'm not gonna go in with concealer first, so I'm not gonna do that. But I'm gonna go in with this foundation first. The Soft Matte Longwear Foundation Pro Filter Fenty by Rihanna. And this is the color 420. It says shake well before applying, so I'm gonna do that, of course. Which I think that only happens when it's like one of those more watery consistencies. So yeah, so this is the bottle. I actually have another one. I think it's like 440, and that's where this review goes wrong, because it's not the first time I've used the foundation, but I feel like she's reformulated since she first had it, because that's when I first tried it out, when she first dropped her line like 3 years ago, I forgot how long ago it was, but I feel like they reformulated. A lot of people didn't like it. I loved it at the time, but also I have dry skin, combo, normal. Technically, this is my first review on the new formula. Let's see what it's called. It is supposed to be full. I think it's more. Let's see. What is it? Coverage?
Yeah, medium to full.
Yeah. Because some of us are stupid like me and we forget what this is. I think it's full coverage though. Uh-oh. Here we go again. There it is. One, two. Okay, I think I'm gonna start with two pump. No, I'm gonna go three. Okay, so we're gonna, I still think this one is, I mean, I like the color. Oh, okay. Me and my sister were talking about it and I'm just like, okay, if I go darker, then I have to conceal more. If I go lighter or my more perfect to my skin tone, then I can just bronze a little bit and it go right kind of next to this. But I also still have the other one because I really didn't use a lot of it. And then it oxidizes a lot. That's what we're talking about. So once it's oxidized, it won't be so yellow. But it definitely looks more yellow than what I thought. But it's very similar to my skin tone, which I am not mad about. I'm going to blend it in my hairline just a little because that wig has to be concealed too. So I really don't think I need any more than this because I am going to be concealing. But I love the color. It is going to oxidize a little bit more. It's going to be a more cocoa-y color.
Okay, I'm back. I left my concealer in the car. So, first concealer. Oh, by the way, I don't know if you can tell, but this definitely oxidized just about a level or two. At first it went on really yellow, but now it's more of a bronzy color that I was talking about.
And it's only been like a couple minutes, maybe like 5 minutes. So I'm going to use the color 410. I didn't already opened it. And this is the Pro Filter Instant Retouch Concealer. So we're just gonna, and I didn't get it in a huge, like 2-3 shades or anything like that because I have concealer. And I was telling my sissy, if I wanted it to be a little brighter, I can just add a touch of the couple of the concealers I already have. But I love that color. And these colors together look good. So we're gonna blend that out. I love the way it blends out. It's easy. It's flawless. It just goes into skin. Like, do I have any concealer on? Hunty. I love that. Okay, so what I use to set is not Fenty, but it's great nonetheless. Why can't I find anything? Okay, so this you can't see the letters on it, but it's the translucent powder by Makeup Revolution, and you have to tap it out, unfortunately. So I'm just gonna sit that, see how these act together. I would have got a Fenty one, but I already spent a lot of money on this stuff. I was like, oh, I have a whole bunch. I have like 4 different setting powders, this one included, so. Oh, nice. And we're just gonna make sure we go right on top of that. Keep her small. I love the fact that on the concealer, it's just, it's so small. The wand is so small. It's perfect for like that dot. It's when you want to carve your nose. That makes me happy. Baking. This is us baking. Let's bake a little under this right here. I don't like to use actual concealer under my contour. I feel like sometimes it's too harsh. And because it's translucent and it blends out the skin, it's just setting that foundation right there in place. Instead of like making it lighter, it's just setting it. Because once it's blended out, it's like skin, I promise you. Do the chin too. Make sure we really do the upper lip. You know, I think this foundation is going to stay. I feel like I don't feel sweaty and hot. Sometimes in the middle of me doing my foundation, I'll be like, oh my God, I'm already sweating this off. So I really love the fact that, you know, I'm not sweating it off yet. So now we're going to contour in and bring some color to this face. I'm using Coco Naughty as my bronzer or contour. Whichever one, they're both the same thing. One's for color, one's for shape. Both are for both. This is what it looks like. Ah! Already about to break it. Cute. I got my fingerprints on it. It's like a little mirror right here, it's cute. Oh my god. I'm trying to be fancy, okay? So I'm gonna open this up real quick. Has the Fenty letters on there. And this one's a little warm, but because I'm this very neutral color, it's not gonna be horrible. Plus it's more of a neutral warm, if that makes sense. It's not super red, it's just kind of balanced neutral. That makes, yeah, see, it just matches the neck very well. I love that it's very buildable powder and it's not super harsh from the first application. So y'all, this is a trick I use. I do have brushes, but they're all dirty. I did makeup over the weekend, and also my own personal brushes are dirty too, so. Oh, wow. That's nice. But yeah, I just pinch it like this. I dip it in, and I just go like this. I kinda bronze the hairline a little, make it look more like scalp, honey. And we're just gonna bronze right under the chin area. And then to blend everything out, we're just gonna go right on top. I would say this is such a good color. It's for everything. This is nice. Now I was using the Morphe bronzer, but it's a little dark. But it still works, but it definitely is darker than this one. It's not yet the bronzer up from this, but it's definitely, I mean, it might be. But the bronzer up from this is a little more red. The one I have is a little more neutral. And maybe that's why I like that one, because I do like a heavier contour. Plus, this is more of a fluffy brush instead of a contour brush. So it's more like adding, it's like bronzing it instead of contouring it right in a specific place. This has nothing to do with the Fenty, but I'm using the J. LaRue in the color White Gold as my highlight. So I'm gonna just use my finger and just lately finger blends have been my whole entire existence. I almost don't feel like I need blush with this bronzer or contour color. It's like red enough, but if I wanted to, I definitely could. But I like the fact that it gives a peachy-ish bronzy thing, like color. Like it gives me that flesh color that I look for sometimes in my bronzer. Today's lip is gonna be interesting. This is the MAC Uniformly Fabulous, and this is the Retro Matte Liquid Lip Color. And I'm just gonna line it. That's how you line your lips. Like if you wanna overdraw, line the bottom of your lip and kiss yourself. We're gonna use this. And this is the all of my old makeup or anything that I used for a really long time. It's just been bumbling around in my makeup kit. It does not have the name of it on there, but this one does on the top. It's Box of Chocolate, or Box of Chocolate 852. In L'Oreal, and this is just a matte lip, I believe. And now we're gonna add a little bit of this Fenty gloss on top. Right on top. Kind of give it more of a demi matte. And I'll be back in just a second with the finished look. Okay, you guys, this is the finished look. I went ahead and actually added another lash just to make it a little more spicy. I really love the bottom lash look. It's just giving that doll-like appearance. I lined and I went ahead and fixed everything up just in case there was any lash and touches I need to do in my makeup before I go to work today. But yes, so this is what the foundation looks like. I love it. This is probably the closest match that I've ever had to my actual skin tone ever. Now, I do like harsher contour. The contour or bronzer powder is very lightweight, so when you add it, you do have to add a couple layers if you like a heavier contour, more dramatic. But other than that, for just the everyday contour, it's pretty good. Like, you can definitely build it up. Everything that I have is buildable except for the foundation, which is full coverage, which technically that means it's buildable as well, but it's already at its fullest stage, which means you don't have to use a lot to get a very beat or full coverage makeup look. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I really, really loved everything that I got. The only thing that I probably could say is I could maybe be a little bit more, I guess, on the dewier side. It's a little more matte than I'm used to, technically, because I use the L'Oreal Infallible Fresh Wear, and that's more dewy. It's still like a soft matte, but it has more of a dewier touch, and you do have to set it. And since I am so used to setting my face, when I do set this one, it's a little bit more on the dry side. I have not sprayed, however, with a finishing spray. I have not done that. I usually don't do that. I haven't done that in a while. I use it every now and then. Not necessary to me. I still feel like this looks good, but for a more skin-like finish and less of a powdery feel and finish, you definitely want to finish off with a setting spray, and I feel like that would help me feel like less matte as far as like the foundation and the formula behind the foundation and the concealer. But everything else is really awesome. And if you're super dry, this might be too matte, so more of a combo normal skin, I think, that would like this formula the best. But anyways, until next time, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Bye.